Hi, everybody. Now, in this part of presentation, we're starting to view how we can submit a new resource using the interface, web interface of Sci-GaIA Open Access Repository. And to do this, first of all, you have to log in the system with your federated authentication. And now you can submit a new record clicking on Submit tab, and the system shows you a list of type of documents that you can upload in the portal. In this case, we will upload a presentation, the presentation of programmatic interaction. After that, you can the system retrieve to you a list of radio buttons that represent the category that you can assign to your resource. In our case, we will use the demo ACFest category. After that, we can click on Submit New Record. Here is the submit form. You have to fill the information of your new resource from this form. There are many types of files. Some are mandatory and some are optional. And for example, the first file is mandatory, and this is the digital object identifier. If the resource that you are uploading has already a DOI, you have to copy it in this text box. Otherwise, you have to click on Reserva DOI, and the system provides you a new DOI and assign it to your new resource. You can select the type of the resource that you are uploading. In our case, we upload a presentation. Here you have to insert the title of the resource. In our case, it's Programmatic Interaction with Open Data Repositories. Here you have to insert the iterators of your resource. If the resource has one or more authors, you have to insert one author per line. And in the first line, you have to insert the main author of this resource. In our case, the main author is in the last line, me. Here you have to insert the abstract of the resource. To do it quickly, I copy it from the agenda. This is an optional file. The number of pages is an optional file. A mandatory file is the language of the resource, in our case, English. Here you have to insert the date of the resource, and we insert day, month, year format. Here you can insert the keyword, the key phrases that you want to assign to your new resource. In our case, for example, we can assign the summer ACFest and repository. Or open data, for example, Sci-GaIA, and each keywords and each key phrases you have to insert one per line. You can insert additional notes or comment to assign to your resource. Important file is the license. In our case, you can select a license of the list. In our case, we use the Creative Commons Attribution 4.0. Here, you can insert the EU project. You can find more project, for example, Indigo. And the system retrieves the complete name of project, but in our case, we will use the Sci-GaIA EU project. Here, if your resource has already reference, you can insert one per line the reference of the resource, inserting the DOI of the resource, the main author of the resource, and the title. After that, you can click on Browse button, and you can upload the presentation. If all OK, you can click on Finish Submission, and you send the upload request to the administrator. Yes. And the administrator get the request, and in a few minutes you can retrieve. You can retrieve the information. For example, you can find your new resource under the collection presentation under the Summer Hackfest. This is an example of uploaded resource where if you want, you show all information, the title, the editors, the DOI, and so on. I start with presentation. I return in the presentation. In the same way, you can upload a new image. You have to select the Demo Hackfest category. And after that, you have to fill all information inside this form, the DOI, the title, the editors, the description of the image. And clicking on Browse button, you can upload the file that you want upload. And in the same way, you can upload a new audio-video recording, selecting the category Demo Hackfest. This is the form that you have to fill. You have to insert the DOI. If the resource has already one, you have to insert it. Otherwise, you have to click on Reserve DOI. You have to insert the editors, the title, the description, and so on. Clicking on Upload Video, you can select the video that you want to upload. And this operation will take more of a few minutes. Be patient. And if all OK, you can click on Finish Submission, and a request is sent to the administrator. And in a few minutes, about in 24 hours, you can retrieve the new video from the repository. Now we are going to view how we can interact with the Open Access Repository using the Search Engine API. There are three kinds of API that you can use: the XML API, the JSON API, and the Python API. About the XML API, this is the syntax. You have to use a base URL and a syntax like this with param and value, a list with param and value. An example of XML API is, for example, get the first 10 record in XML format. To this, we have to use this request where we use the JREC param that stands for jump to record. For example, the one for the first hit. RG record stands for records in group of. And for example, 10 hits per page. And param OF stands for output format. And in our case, it's XM format to retrieve the output in XML format. And if you set the JREC param and the RG param appropriately, you can paginate the output. For example, using this request, you get the first param, the first n param of the repository. If you use this query, you get the second 10 param of the repository, starting from the record number 11, JREC 11. In the same way, you can get the third 10 records of the repository using this request where the rect param is equals to 22. If you don't set the RG param by default is set to the highest value. And in more of case, this value is 10. An example of a query, another example of a query is get the first 10 record that contains the string Sci-GaIA Winter School in the title. To do this, we have to use the first, not this, the first request, where you have to use two params that are the P params that is the pattern, is the query that you want to do, the string that you want to search. You must use F-filed that stands for file to search within, and you specify, using this param, where you are searching the string. Another type of query is this. You can get a record, a specific record, using given DOI. If you have the DOI, you can use it to retrieve all information about this resource. To do this, you have to use this request, where you use the pparam, and the value of the pparam is DOI colon the DOI of the resource that you are searching. Another type of query can be get all records uploaded from a given data to another given data. To do this, you have to use the param D1 and D2, that are the first date and the second date in year, month, day format. This is an example of a query that retrieves the information in XML format. The XML format covers the mark XML tag. If you want to use the JSON output, the JSON API, you have to set the OF param on rect.json value. If you want to use the JSON API, you can use all the params that you can use with the XML API. This is an example of query that you can do with the JSON format. This is the same of the query that we have to do with XML API. The difference stands on OF value. Is rect.json. In the same way, you can get the all records uploaded from a given data to another given data using DD1 and D2 param, and OF equals to rect.json. This is an example of output in JSON format. You can use the name of the param, for example, abstract, creation date, keyword, to filtering the result of the query. For example, you can use this, you can get only the abstract, the title, and the authors of a resource using a new param that is OT, that stands for output tags. In this case, the system retrieves to you, show to you only the abstract, the title, the authors of each resource. Now, the Invenio search engine can be called from within your Python programs, and you can use all the same param that we use for XML API and JSON API. If you want to know more about the param that you can use, you can visit this GUID. Now, we are going to view how you can download one or more record. If you want to download records, you will need the public key and private key that are provided by the system. And you need of a signature that you have to calculate. How? You have to write your query that must contain the API key with the value of your public key, and pass it with the private key to the HMIA C method that produce like output the signature. If you want to download one or more records, for example, from your script, you have to use this query that contains the API key and signature that you have just calculated. If you want now upload one or more records, you have need to send an authorization request for your IP address to the administrator and create a MarkXML file as input. The MarkXML file, your file XML, is more important because this file contains all records that you want to upload. And once you create the file and your IP is authorized, you can use this cure to upload the file. The administrator after accept the request. If you want to know more about the upload, you can visit this GitHub. But now we start to talk of your file XML. The file XML must support the MARC format that is the standard in the library world. And your file must contain a tag collection. And the tag collection can contain one or more records. Each record represents a resource, the resource that you want to upload. And each record has more data file tag. Each data file tag represents a MarkXML tag. An example can be the tag 024, that is the tag that specifies the DOI of the resource. Another tag can be the 100 tag that specifies the main author of the resource. And here you can insert all the information of the author. For example, the subfile code E is the name of the author. The subfile code J is the orchid of the author. And this is a complete example of a record that you can upload inside the Sci-GaIA repository in Venue-based. Some of these tags are mandatory. Others are optional. A mandatory tag can be the 024 tag that is the DOI identifier of the resource. Another tag mandatory is the 100, that is the first author of the resource. Some of this file, some of this tag must be uniquely. So, for example, the main author, you can have in one record only one tag with code 100. If your resource has more of one author, you have to insert the other authors using the tag with code 700. So your records can have one or more tag 700, but only one tag 100. Other type of tags are, for example, the tag 653, that is the keyword tag. You can have in one record more of this tag. The tag, for example, 980 is a mandatory tag, that is the collection of the resource, and you can have only one of this tag. If you want to know more about the old tag, you can use other tag, but it is a complete example to upload a new record inside the Sci-GaIA. You can visit this GUID and read all information about each tag. Another way to interact with the Sci-GaIA repository is using the search engine based on OAPMH standard protocol. The Sci-GaIA is publicly available at the endpoint segment. You can use this endpoint to get, for example, detailed information about an available set of the repository. You can list, for example, all the records in Dublin Core format using this request. If you have an OI identifier, you can retrieve all information of a record using this request. And this is an example of output of a request where the system shows you all information about the resource with a given OI identifier and show you all the resource, all the Dublin Core metadata of the resource.
Thank you very much, Carla.
Thank you.